Good afternoon, Rowan. It's the 12th of July 2018 and it's just after 3 p.m. And obviously this is my usual Friday evening video being recorded once again on Thursday to reassure you that I won't be seducing any priests over the weekend. I won't be hanging around the Catholic parish of St Urban's in order to try and bump into any pretend astrophysicists in order to save your skin. And I won't be coming out as a lesbian either, in order to save your gigantic ego. So everything is exactly the same as usual. Nothing ever changes. Anyway, I'm making a video about a clip from a dialogue that you were in on the 5th of July 2018. You'll see the details of that on the screen in a minute, but it's your usual sophistry and disingenuous behaviour, but I won't bother putting any definitions of those up because I've done it before, and in any case you redefine words, don't you, so there's no point. But you can rest assured that nothing's going to change, you're not going to get your own way, and laughing off the fact that you tried to get your leg over and you wanted sexual favours in exchange for ordination, laughing about that isn't going to get you off the hook. You're just a psychopathic scumbag. You've got no conscience whatsoever. And I've already made a video anyway about the kind of people you were promoting and recommending for ordination in the church in Wales. You didn't have so much control over that in Canterbury, did you? Because the diocese was really taken out of your hands, so other people were really making those decisions, not you. And I've also talked about how your modus operandi is taken from straight from the CIA manual of simple sabotage, that you promote useless people in order to demoralise other people, more competent people, when they see really useless and abusive people being rewarded and people who are competent and virtuous being punished. And there's also a number of other things in your modus operandi from the CIA manual of simple sabotage, but I've talked about that in several videos before, so I won't go over it now because I'm having some technical issues with my phone. So this may be my last video for over a week, but you can rest assured that until the time when my technical issues are resolved, I will not be seducing any priests, hanging around the Catholic parish of St Urban's hoping to bump into any pretend astrophysicists in order to save your skin, and I won't be coming out as a lesbian in order to save your gigantic ego. So I'm going to have to make this video as quick as I can. And if I can't make a video for a long time, that's more time for me to be dreaming about my beloved, because he's so wonderful and we're made for each other and we just can't wait to be together on our bed of roses, on our silk sheets, having a really good time in each other's arms, resisting tyrannous authorities. And also, of course, I'll have more time to be turning up and making a citizen's arrest of you for terrorism and also to ask you those awkward questions that I've still got up my sleeve. So that's it for now. So until the next time, whenever that may be, hasta la próxima.
What was your response to the work when you first saw it, Ron?
It's a work that actually went on being very important to me whenever I was in the cathedral. And I was particularly conscious of it because quite often in my time we would have a session the day before the ordination services where the new priests and deacons were, a session in that space for me to give my pearls of wisdom to the candidates for ordination. And quite often in my time we would have a session the day before the ordination services where the new priests and deacons were, a session in that space.
Give me life, give me action.
pearls of wisdom to the candidates for ordination. And quite often I felt rather like saying, don't bother to say anything or think anything. Just sit here with that in front of you. Because all you've said about the literal openness of this.
I don't like if you love me, love me, love me. I'll drive you crazy.
Because all you've said about the literal openness of this. That comes across.
Oh! Oh, yes! 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 Oh! Yes! 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 Oh! Oh! Oh!
I'll have what she's having.
That comes across particularly vividly, simply because, of course, it allows the air to move. Which means that as you breathe and as you speak in that space, something shifts. It shifts very slowly and it shifts very unpredictably. Which means there's no one definitive fix on it. And somehow that subtle, almost imperceptible shifting, swaying, circulating that goes on in midair gave me a lot to think about in terms of the absolutely cooperative nature of the space we inhabit as human beings.
Ground control to Major Tom, your circuit's dead. There's something wrong, can you hear me, Major Tom?
The absolutely cooperative nature of the space we inhabit as human beings. We don't stand still, we don't see everything from one individual point of view. We breathe, we speak. That breathing, that speaking shifts.
Hello, hello, baby, I have only got one call. I have been arrested and I'm in a jail cell. What did you say? God, I hate AT&T. Come on, break me out of here, now can you free me?
What did you say? Oh, you're breaking up on me. Sorry, I cannot hear you, I'm kinda busy.
That breathing, that speaking shifts. And yet, there it is still. You know, the body is there, a body, a place. We talked about this the other day. A place rather than a thing, I think, was your expression, Attie. Mm. And that resonated enormously with me because.
I know what you're thinking, baby, and if I was to tell you, you'd think I was talking in centimetres.
That resonated enormously with me because of that sense of a place we cooperate in. And I don't mean by that a place where we come to cooperate about something else, but a place where we come to understand our cooperative nature, our communion-oriented nature, if you like. I don't mean by that a place where we come to cooperate about something else, but a place where we come to understand our cooperative nature, our communion-oriented nature. But I must throw one other thing in about the nails. But I must throw one other thing in about the nails. Obviously, the imagery of a human body made of nails has any number of resonances in a space like a church. But I also had a much less elevated thought about that, which was that we tack messages onto boards, onto surfaces. And I found myself thinking, what are the messages tacked onto that place, that space?
what are the messages packed onto that place, that space? All the messages have blown away long since. But the drawing pins are still on the board, as it were. And that gave me something to reflect on, something I tried writing about, actually. But that was my first set of responses.
I think I